Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this tutorial, I will show you guys how to create this cool free wave background design in Adobe Photoshop. All right, so let's get started. All right, guys, first thing, I'm going to create a layer group in here, and inside the layer group I will create a new layer. All right, now let's go into our gradients in here and open up the gradient setting palette. Okay, so by default we have these presets and the solid gradient type. For this example, we need to select the noise from here. Okay, so once you open up, select the noise gradient type. So once you select the noise gradient, you guys can see we have these nice colorful lines in here which apply these colors based on these RGB values. Okay, so if you guys want, you can restrict these colors by moving these. Let's say if you don't want darker tones, you can bring these down in here. If you don't want lighter tone, you can bring these to the darker side, and you have to click the restrict option. And I like this color set, so I'm just going to select this for the first set of colors. So I'm just going to select okay and select your layer and press G or your gradient, and now I'm going to apply this gradient from bottom to top like this. All right, okay, so this will be our first gradient sample, and let's go in and create a new layer. And for this, let's go back into our gradient, and to modify these colors, you can just press on this randomize option. So every time when you press this randomize option, you can see these gradient sets are changing. Okay, and as I said, if you don't want certain colors, you can just move these colors to lighter areas. And when you move these colors, all these colors will be based on these range. Okay, so you can select the range of colors, but you have to select restrict colors in here. Then it will apply to those colors. Okay, so now when you press randomize, all these colors are based on these range, right, guys? Okay, and this looks better. But if you want to change the contrast in between these colors, you can go to the roughness and increase the roughness. So when you increase, you can see the contrast is changing. We have more darker and lighter areas in between, so it will be very rough. All right, so I think this look better now. Once you're satisfied, you can just simply select okay, and for this I'm going to apply this gradient in here. All right, guys, looks good. And if you want to modify any colors, or you want to make a little bit brightness and contrast anything, you can just simply press Ctrl L, which will bring the levels, and in here you can edit this. For me, I just need to bring this one a little bit darker, and highlight also a little bit darker. I think this look better. I'm just going to select okay. All right, now let's go back and create another layer. Again, go back to the gradient and let's press on randomize. I think this look better. Yeah, this is even more better. All right, so I'm just going to select this color and make a gradient in here. Okay, cool. So now let's apply one more layer. This will be the last color for our samples. For this, again, I'm going to go back to the gradients and let's start randomizing the colors. I think, this is completely different, which is what I wanted. So I'm just going to select OK, and then I will apply this in here. Okay, guys, and don't worry too much about the colors, guys. We can always go back and apply gradient layers on top of these colors and change these colors later on. All right, so for now, we will stick to these four samples. And now I will close this layer group, and I will keep this layer group for future use. And I will right click and duplicate this layer for continue with this artwork. So just duplicate this group. All right, and we can hide this one in here. Open up the duplicated group, and you can hide all these, and you can select the base layer in here, the first layer. And now I'm going to make this one a little bit thinner. So I'm just going to press Ctrl T, which will bring the transform settings, and hold the shift key and bring the size a little bit smaller like this. All All right, I think this looks good. And now right click and select the wrap. So now you guys can see we have these divisions in here, vertically and horizontally also. If you guys don't see this option, you can go in here and activate the wrap show always guide. So that means that the guides will be shown in here, so we can easily move this shape. So what I'm looking for in here is I want a shape like this going all the way like this, and then it will come back in here, and thickness wise it will gradually increase and then decrease to a pointy corner. All right, so that's the shape I'm looking for. All right, so now let's start modifying the shape using the mesh. All right, so let's start from here. I want it to be like this. This one also we can bring it here. This one we can bring it down. And we gradually want it to be pointier like this. So we can zoom in also. We can also move these towards X side as well, so we can have this closed like this. All right, all right guys, more or less we have the shape we wanted. Now we can simply press OK, which will apply to the shape. Now I'm going to make a copy from this shape, Control J, and let's hide this one for now and select this shape. And again, you can go back and select Control G. Now again, I'm going to select the wrap. Now this time the wrap will apply to this shape in here, so we can easily edit this shape the way we want it. Okay, so I'm just going to bring this one behind like this. All right, and this one inside, this one like this. Okay, this is what I'm looking for. I want this sharp corner like that. All right, so this is the shape I'm looking for, this shape in here. I'm just going to press OK, and now I will select the second one in here. Let's bring this one behind, and we can bring this one a little bit smaller like this. Also can rotate if you want to. All right, and this one will be, let's make it, I have to select this one in here. Let's make it a little bit smaller and place it in here like this. All right, now again Control C, right click and wrap, and now we can edit this shape. Okay, so this shape will be something along this line in here. All right, maybe rotate a bit like this. You can select both of them and make them a little bit smaller. Okay, let's start editing a bit again. Alright guys, so these two shapes are fine. Now I will do the same for other layers in here also. So I will make this part faster. You guys already know what I'm doing. I'm just using the wrap to modify the shape to fit into our artwork. Alright. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so now we have our shape in here. Looks good. Now I'm going to close this group and let's select the background layer. We can unlock this background layer and let's apply a gradient for the background. This time I'm going to select a solid color and we can apply any colors, guys. For this, I'm going to select a preset from here, from the purple. I think let's apply this one in here. Okay. And I'm going to select this gradient option and let's apply like this. Okay. And we can increase the contrast of this gradient. Let's make it a little bit more lighter like this. All right. Okay, so later we can change the background. For now, I will stick to this background. It's just a guide for us. Now let's go back into these gradients. And now what I want to do is I want to apply shadows for each of these layers. So we will have some 3D depth to these lines. Okay, for that, let's start from the one on top, this one in here. Okay, and underneath this one, I'm going to create a new layer. Let's bring it behind this this layer in here. And for this, I'm going to select the black color and let's go into the brushes and select a soft brush. And this one is fine. And the opacity, I'm going to bring it to 22. All right. And the mood, I'm going to change it to multiple. All right. So now select the pressure sensitivity if you want to and increase the brush size. And now we can draw the shadows in here like this. Okay. All right. And now I'm going to do the same for these also. Let's select this one in here and create a new layer and bring the layer behind and let's apply the shadow. All right, guys. So now I'm going to repeat the same for all of these layers. So let's make this part faster also. All right, guys, now we can apply the shadows to these areas also. Based on the light, we can have some light shadows in these bending areas so that it will look more realistic in the 3D environment. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do in here. I'm going to select this layer and going to apply a new layer. And we can bring the brush to maybe even less opaque, maybe 13. And now we can apply that light shadows area in here. Okay. Only in these bending areas. Okay. You can do the same in here as well. We can bring this layer to the top so we can apply to all of these. A little bit in here. And in here a bit. All right, guys, I think we have almost done with our design. And if you guys want, you can also have a highlighted area like the shadow for certain places. I'm not going to do that for this artwork. This look nice now. Okay, now I'm going to close this group and going to make a copy, Control J, and the group behind I'm going to make as a smart object. So right click and make convert to smart object. All right, guys, so now we have this group behind. We can make a couple of copies if you want to. First, I'm just going to rotate it. Okay, make sure when you're rotating time, you don't see any edges hanging out. I think this look better. All right, and let's make one more copy. Now select the layer behind and this one again make some rotations like this, and you guys can make it bigger also if you want to. All right, looks good now. And again, I'm going to make a new layer on top, and for this I'm going to have that shadow effect underneath the layer on top. Okay, for this I'm going to select the brush again. Let's bring it to 25. Okay, and now let's start painting in here. These areas where you see the layer behind. So we will have this nice 3D depth to these layers, which are behind our main design. And same underneath this layer also, I'm going to create a new layer. For this, I'm going to draw the same shadows. This one I will apply a little bit more darker. All right, guys. Now, if you want, you can select these and apply a little bit blur to them. So go to blur and Gaussian blur, and for this let's apply one, and the one in the background go to Gaussian blur and apply maybe two. Okay, so it will be a bit more blurred than this. So this is our closest object. All right, guys, looks good. Now you can apply that text effect, which you are guys already know. I have shown how to design that in our previous tutorial. You guys can look in here. And so this is just one example what you can do with this type of designs. There are so many things you can do. The sky is the limit. So you guys can explore and create your own designs based on this type of artworks. All right, guys. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.